I went to the woods because I wished to live deliberately, to front only the essential facts of life, and not, when I came to die, discover that I had not lived. I wanted to live deep and suck out all the marrow of life. To live so sturdily and Spartan-like is to reduce it to its lowest terms. And, if it proved to be mean, to get the whole and genuine meanness of it. Or if it were sublime, to know it by experience and to give a true account of it. When I wrote the following pages, or rather the bulk of them, I lived alone in the woods, a mile from any neighbor, in a house which I had built myself, on the shore of Walden Pond, in Concord, Massachusetts, and earned my living by the labor of my hands only. When I first took up my abode in the woods, my house was not finished. It was a pleasant hillside where I worked, covered with pine woods, through which I looked out on the pond, and a small open field in the woods where pines and hickories were springing up. Hmm.
July 4th, 1845. Dearest Henry, congratulations on the start of your experiment. I hope that the work goes well and the ideas are fruitful. Mr. Emerson says you are intent to devour yourself in our woods, but I hope that you will remember to take good care and keep yourself well. Mother worries, as do I. Your loving sister, Sophia.
My house was on the side of a hill, immediately on the edge of the larger wood, in the midst of a young forest of pitch pines and hickories, and half a dozen rods from the pond, to which a narrow footpath led down the hill. In my front yard grew the strawberry, blackberry, and life everlasting, John's wort and goldenrod, shrub oaks and sand cherry, blueberry and groundnut. Interesting. The necessaries of life for man in this climate may, accurately enough, be distributed under the several heads of food, shelter, clothing, and fuel. For not till we have secured these are we prepared to entertain the true problems of life with freedom and a prospect of success. There is some of the same fitness in a man's building his own house that there is in a bird's building its own nest. But if men constructed their dwellings with their own hands and provided food for themselves and families simply and honestly enough, the poetic faculty would be universally developed, as birds universally sing when they are so engaged. Thank you.
Huh.
My residence was more favorable, not only to thought, but to serious reading, than a university. And though I was beyond the range of the ordinary circulating library, I had more than ever come within the influence of those books which circulate round the world. The grand necessity, then, for our bodies is to keep warm, to keep the vital heat in us. Interesting. Interesting. Mm-hmm. Interesting. Interesting. I kept Homer's Iliad on my table through the summer, though I looked at his page only now and then.
Hmm.
I am no more lonely than the loon in the pond that laughs so loud, or than Walden Pond itself. I am more lonely than a single mullein or dandelion in a pasture, or a bean leaf or sorrel, or a horsefly or a bumblebee. I am no more lonely than the millbrook, or a weathercock, or the north star, or the south wind, or an April shower, or a January thaw, or the first spider in a new house.
July 1845. Dear Henry, you've told me yourself that it is difficult to begin anything without borrowing, and I know that you can use an axe, so I've left one for you in my front yard by the chopping stump. Do come by any time to fetch it. Perhaps we can discuss the new lecture I am working on while you are here. Your friend, Ralph Waldo Emerson.
As I sit at my window this summer afternoon, hawks are circling about my clearing, the tantivy of wild pigeons flying by two and threes athwart my view, or perching restless on the white pine boughs behind my house, give a voice to the air. A fish hawk dimples the glassy surface of the pond and brings up a fish. A mink steals out of the marsh before my door and seizes a frog by the shore. The sedge is bending under the weight of the reed birds flitting hither and thither, and for the last half hour I have heard the rattle of railroad cars, now dying away.
Huh.